The defeated opposition candidate in Drive Congo's presidential election has vowed to challenge the result in court. Martin Fayulu told the BBC the people of the nation deserved to know the truth of the election, which he said had led to a coup. Another opposition candidate, Felix Tshisekedi, was declared the winner amid accusations of a power-sharing deal with the outgoing president. Several deaths and injuries have been reported in the wake of the results. The election was to choose a successor to Joseph Kabila, who has been in office for 18 years. The result, if confirmed, would create the first orderly transfer of power since independence from Belgium in 1900, and sixth the influential Catholic Church, which posted 40,000 election observers, said the result did not match its findings. Speaking to the BBC's Africa editor, Fogo King, Mr. Fayulu said he would challenge the declared result in the Constitutional Court. "I will do whatever is possible for me to do to get the truth, because the Congolese won," Tshisekedi, he said. Mr. Fayulu admitted such a challenge would have little chance of success as the court was composed of Kabila's people, but he said he did not want to give his opponents any chance to say he had not followed the law. Felix Tshisekedi has been nominated by Mr. Kabila to perpetrate the Kabila regime. "Because today the bosses, Kabila," Mr. Fayulu said, "Mr. Kabila cannot stay and make an arrangement with someone who will not have any power." Mr. Tshisekedi knows himself that he did not win. Mr. Fayulu said he feared there would be violence if the Electoral Commission did not give the true figures, polling station by polling station, and that it was the right of all Congolese to demonstrate according to the law. Thousands of supporters of Mr. Tshisekedi took to the streets to celebrate, but those who backed Mr. Fayulu also came out in protest. Violent scenes were reported in Kikwit, where at least two policemen and two civilians were said to have been killed. There were reports of deaths. Several hundred students protesting against the result and being dispersed by tear gas in the town of Mbandaka. Protests were also reported in Kisangani, but the south, where Mr. Tshisekedi has broad support, was mainly in celebration. United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres has urged all sides to refrain from violence, and widespread unrest has not yet been reported. According to the National Electoral Commission, SENI, Mr. Tshisekedi received 38.5% of the vote in the 30 December election. The full results were turnout was reported to be 48%. Mr. Tshisekedi held his victory, owing to be the president of all Drive Congolese. His spokesman, Louis Diangalame, said there was never any deal with Mr. Kabila. Mr. Kabila's ruling party, whose candidate came a distant third, has not yet contested the result, although it did not rule out doing so. Abroad, the response was a mix of appealing for calm and calling for clarification. The African Union leader, Moussa Mahamat, said any dispute should be resolved peacefully by turning to the relevant laws. The United States held the courageous Congolese voters and called for a clarification of questions which have been raised regarding the electoral count. The EU appealed for all parties to abstain from violence. France did challenge the declared result, saying it was not consistent with the true results. French Foreign Minister Geneva Drive said. On the 5th of it, Mr. Sayuru was the leader coming out of these elections.